that was too loud.
I should say so. Yeah. Should we try again?
Yeah, yeah, go again.
Okay, we're in Nuneaton, England, at the Haribamira full-scale wind tunnel.
It's usually used for studying the aerodynamics of different things like cars, but today we'll be testing ourselves in the wind tunnel in a very highly requested video. I feel like I've got 8 years worth of emails saying, get in a wind tunnel. So we did.
Well, the thing is, I used to be way more aerodynamic than I am now, so it's going to be quite a challenge for me.
Well, I feel like we've waited the perfect amount of time to make this video.
Great.
Why don't we start by cranking this thing up to the max and getting some lovely phantom shots of us trying to stay upright.
What's your pose going to be like?
Maybe one of these or like...
Okay. Need to practice. I'm just going to do this.
So this wind tunnel goes upwards of 80 miles an hour, and you can't really just have a bunch of lights and cameras loose. So we've got everything tethered down, weighted down, even the crew are tethered in. One thing to note about this wind tunnel, it's probably common in wind tunnels, is that it sucks.
It doesn't blow.
It doesn't blow. It sucks all the air out this way, and there's a load of grates at the other end.
I never really knew that about wind tunnels, but I guess that's probably true for all of them, because otherwise you're going to get the buffeting of the fans, whereas because it's sucking, it's like really clean air.
Yeah, and on the other side of the fan, it's very turbulent and much harder to measure aerodynamics.
All right. Okay.
Ready for the thumbs up?
Yeah, let's go. Okay, we're good. Look at him sat in there with his perfectly nice air-conditioned room. Okay. This is already scary.
It is spinning.
Doesn't mess around. I feel like I could lose my, you know, like my sleeves half on, half off.
Yeah.
I feel like this could go. I feel like I'd totally lose it.
Should we go and see what that looked like? Oh, I'm breathless.
Yeah. Oh, my mouth's so dry.
Look at that.
Imagine if you did a 100-meter sprint and they cut to the slow-mo and you look like that. They'd be like, bloody hell, this guy can run.
Well, if you ran 80 miles an hour, then that's exactly what it would look like.
This is the least flattering. Like, it displays all the gut, receded hairline.
Yeah.
It's got it all.
Yeah, I can tell, I can see.
All right, Dan, repoed the camera to the side. A nice profile shot. Should really show the flappy lab coats and the amount of lean that we can get on this.
Do you think I'll be able to get, you'll be able to get more lean than me because you weigh less, or do you think
Probably.
I'll be able to?
Maybe.
All right, okay, I think we're ready. Let's go, let's hit it.
Yeah.
That's a full 45 right there.
Oh, you're so good at this compared to me.
Really struggling at it. You are properly at 45 degrees, maybe even lower.
Proud of that.
I'm going to try a jump. Might be dangerous.
The thing is, I weigh so much more than you. I'm going to go flying back and I'm just going to be like...
All right, you ready?
Yeah, I guess so. Let's go. So I was trying to see if 80 miles an hour is enough to be sat in a wind chair.
And it worked.
It worked.
You just sat down on air.
For like 5 seconds, I just sat there like this. Like
I was trying to grab the back of my lab coat to make a little parachute, but yeah, it was bloody hard to get it. Got to go.
Yeah, exactly. It's hard to hold on to it.
Just leapt forwards into the wind.
Whoa.
I actually caught air.
You did. It's pushed you backwards. And you?
That's purely blowing me back because I made sure to jump a little bit forwards.
Yeah.
Why don't we start testing some elements?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, like real, like water, like fire?
Just like water.
Oh, sorry, probably not fire. Okay, just not fire. All right.
I feel good about this. Dan?
Yes.
How do you feel about this?
Not good.
I've got some like light rain there and some not so light rain there.
Why? We haven't even started yet.
All right, let's crank the wind.
Oh, man.
Thank you.
a bit wet. I didn't stand a chance.
Oh, man.
What did that feel like?
Like I was literally in a storm of some sort of magnitude of I've never heard of.
You look like a certain singer from a 90s music video. Oh, you can see.
Look, it's turning into thicker water when it goes past my ear.
It's splatting off your face, mistifying, and then you're leaving like mist trails.
Yeah.
Look at that.
It's like I'm a plane going through the air, causing mist.
We've deliberately backlit this, so the rain shows up really well against the black background.
Straight in my head as well.
Didn't go for my body, straight for the head.
Well, yeah. So yeah, and that was like full stream. You can see how it mystifies it all.
Oh, yeah, the wind's so powerful that it just...
That is really raining sideways. It's like smacking.
Look at it underneath there. It's just completely streaming.
It's hitting
away.
You so hard that it'll bounce off, and it will literally bounce away from the wind. It's so much force.
So the way the hose is, it's like a stream, right?
Yeah.
I'm turning it into a mister.
Yeah.
It goes into me and turns into mist.
It's a two-part misting system.
Yeah.
And you're part two. The rain was all right. I think we need something slightly more torrential.
All right.
Do you reckon this is torrential enough?
Oh.
Not bad.
Is that a bucket of it?
I'm gonna do well to actually bloody get this into the air. It's gonna be well hard.
You're just gonna hit my legs with it.
I'm either gonna splash your legs a lot, or I'm gonna let go of it and the whole thing will knock you out.
Oh no, I don't let go of that bucket.
Well, I'm not gonna do it on purpose, am I? All right, let's
tether up. I haven't thought of that. I'm gonna get my block knocked off.
That's what I was dealing with the bucket. I basically, right, I threw it.
Yeah.
Water, like, air got inside it. It was gone from that point. The air was swirling around inside to go like, like, it was soaking me. And I was just trying to hold it. It was going, it was like a kite. Oh. Bugger. Let's take a look at that. Look, from the previous attempts, the water that's still on you is blowing off. It's actually an air dryer.
Oh. You nailed my face there.
I did.
Oh, you soaked me. That looks cool. Look at my face.
It's like 90 degree shutter.
Windshield. Has it ever rained that hard?
I don't know, like a bucket's worth?
Yeah.
Maybe. Oh, that is absolute.
That looks like it's mist.
An absolute torrent. You can actually see the goggles flapping against your face.
Oh, yeah. And my cheek is going. Look at my cheek going.
A little bit of chest hair going. All right, here comes the
it's
torrent.
It's like proper opened up chest hair.
That is proper sideways rain. Oh, it's magic. As the water bounces off your face, it bounces off, but all like the same distance before it gets blown back.
Oh,
so you end up with like this weird like white mist mask.
It's like a
just
halo around my face.
Sat around. Look at that liquid. Oof. You must have drank a lot of it there.
I think so.
You gotta love that. So you said to me you wanted to do a test.
Well, you know when you're like blowing up a balloon and everything, blowing up a balloon?
Yeah.
I brought my own balloon. I thought I wanted to try blowing up a balloon in the wind tunnel.
Okay.
Yep. Okay. So I'll just.
Yeah, that kind of balloon.
Yeah, it's a balloon.
All right.
It's a slippy balloon.
You know one of those lubricated balloons?
Yeah. The see-through party ones.
Okay. Let's see what happens with this.
Okay. Here we go.
It's a condom. Without a doubt, the stupidest thing I've ever recorded in slow motion in my life.
It was like a windsock.
What have our lives become?
Look at my face, I'm enjoying myself so much.
It was going like this for ages, and I was like, stretch it.
As soon as I like did when like even slightly stretched it, it just went, whoa.
Look how big it got.
It's huge.
It's flubbling all over the place.
Why do you need different size ones if that's how big you get?
I saw that little twinkle in your eye, the little idea twinkle. Come up with a new sport, haven't you?
I have. You know how you get like sailboats and stuff?
Yeah.
How about wind-powered skateboard?
Yeah.
Powered by balloon?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna lay here, let the wind inflate my balloon,
And hopefully it will have enough power to pull me along like a rocket.
This is a world first, this. I don't think this sport has ever been done.
I wouldn't have thought so. I'm very excited.
It's offensive the amount of effort gone into a place like this, and then we show up and do that.
Yeah, so it's for scientific testing purposes of automobiles, and then, oh!
There was definitely technique to it as well. I was like, I've got this.
Something about your flat hair with your smug face with that flapping in the wind.
Goodness gracious me, that was funny.
I've got a headache now after that. It was just so much fun.
Well, that was absolutely insane. I've never operated a phantom in such mental condition.
You're telling me I'm stood here doing this outro and I feel like I'm like this.
Like, because there's no... It's
prepared. I'm like, oh, yeah, wait, I'm not in there anymore.
At one point, I was, like, trying to steer because the camera kept panning in the wind and then I was holding it and the screen started flapping around. I was like... but somehow, we got some very usable, lovely phantom shots.
Yeah, it should be a test whether you can be a good camera operator if you can withstand those conditions.
Yeah, I feel like...
Hurricane Category 1 against me as well, because I had the wind.
Yeah, I feel like I need a certificate or something.
Yeah, it was all because these propellers are actually from a World War II bomber, which is pretty crazy, I thought.
Yeah. Well, hopefully you enjoyed that video. Big thanks to Hariba and Myra for letting us use this massive wind tunnel. Make sure you check out part 2, and feel free to subscribe to the Slow Mo Guys.